Welcome to Los Angeles Religious Education Congress. This evening, I have the great pleasure of interviewing Valerie MacRae in our sacred space this year. Valerie, thank you so much for taking time for us this evening.
Oh, it's a pleasure. It's really wonderful to be in here. Oh,
I'm just thrilled. We met over the phone, and now to have an opportunity to talk to you in the space that you create every year and have for several years is just delightful. I can hear God speaking in so many different ways here, and that's what I'd like to talk about this evening and share with our folks who are not able to be here. But before we begin, I'd like you to tell me what's happening behind us over here in the sacred space.
What's happening behind is that we have the sacred space is set up in different sections. So we have the Eucharist, where there's adoration of the Eucharist in what we call our chapel. And between the chapel and our labyrinth here, we have an exhibit of art. And this particular exhibit is the last, actually, the Stations of the Cross. And we have taken down all the walls so that the sacred space is one big open area. And adjacent to that, we would have an area for musicians to perform and add ambient music. And then on this side, we have our labyrinth.
And then I see surrounding us a lot of art. And this year, I'm seeing, isn't this Healing Petals, Sister Liz?
Yes, we have Sister Liz with Healing Petals. And Sister Liz is a cancer survivor. And what she did was create images that have been used in hospitals. And people meditate on these. At first glance, they may not look spiritual, but as you use them as a meditative visual to help you heal, actually, God is the greatest designer. And if you look at these petals and as these beautiful images that Sister Liz has created, you can see deep inside of them, and some part of that reflects you. And I think the healing that we all have the capability of hopefully doing. So she has beautiful images.
Oh, my. So. Well, now, every year you actually select art so that you have both the music and the art that reflects what comes to mind that particular year.
Yes.
How do you come up with the art and select and display them so beautifully every year?
What I really want to say is that there's a great partnership with the Holy Spirit. It is not myself that creates this. It's the Holy Spirit that creates it. And what makes this a sacred space are the people that come and visit. And the human experience, the human, you know, intimacy that happens here. So the art kind of comes to us. And artists will say, I have a group of art, I'm interested in displaying it. Or Sister Edith actually saw this work and invited Sister Liz to bring her art to sacred space.
Oh my.
So it becomes a serendipity, it becomes synchronicity. It's the Holy Spirit. So I don't go out searching for artists. They sort of, you know, we find each other.
They come to you?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes, they're guided to you.
Yes.
Now, you've been doing this for quite a while, haven't you?
Yes.
Several years?
I'm guessing 7, 8 years, something like that. We began with Cheryl Lange and Sister Edith Pendergrass decided that what Congress really needed was a place where we could decompress. Because you can hear all the workshops and go to all the events, but if you don't have a chance to sit and be still and listen to God's voice infusing life, then you go home and you're left with a lot of brochures. So you need that place to decompress, maybe to rest your feet, maybe to just listen to the quiet. And so it began in Hall E, which was like a dungeon. And so we created our first sacred space there. And it went over so well that it's been something that we've
elaborated on every year and added to every year, and it just gets better and better. Mm. And we have, this year we've added some Gregorian chants, and they are done. We have a brochure. The name skips me right now, but it's absolutely phenomenal, the combination of music, visuals, and also the walking meditation of the labyrinth. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. the best, the Holy Spirit, I mean, the Eucharist. And the Holy Spirit combined.
Well, we also have reconciliation that happens throughout the day as well, don't we?
Let us not forget reconciliation.
Yes. I know when I walked by earlier today that the lines, as expected, were snaked all the way back and then back up again.
Yes.
And of course, reconciliation is offered in several different languages.
Yes.
So God bless the priests who
come and volunteer their time.
Exactly.
It is exciting to see people lining up for reconciliation. That doesn't often happen.
Mm-hmm.
But here, there's something that moves you. Mm-hmm. And it's a beautiful, beautiful experience. Then we do mind, body, spirit here. You know?
Exactly. You're really touching all of the senses.
Yes.
And people kneeling and feeling under their feet the labyrinth cloth.
It's very textural.
And it is.
Use all our senses.
Yes.
All of our senses.
Because God does speak to us in so many different ways.
Yes.
Each of us created uniquely. Each of us hearing Him in different ways.
Yes.
And that is really, I think, the power that I've seen over the years here in the sacred space.
Absolutely.
I really thank you for your contribution.
I hope you're
going to
walk the labyrinth.
You know I will.
Yeah, okay. Very good.
And I wanted to point out, interestingly enough, over on this side, I see that you have a John August Swanson.
We have John August Swanson. We also have St. John's Bible. It's just they have been blessing us with their beautiful artwork each year. And it's just, there's such a collage of artwork here, so many different visuals. And John August is just a brilliant artist. Mm-hmm. I just love his work.
Well, you know, I was captured by his art several years ago when I came up.
Yes, you bought The Last Supper.
I did.
Which is the one that's being featured in the sacred space this year.
It is just beautiful and moving, which reminds me of a piece of art that you have produced.
How kind of you.
The women's hands.
Yes.
Feeding each other.
Now you're giving away the secret. Yes, we do have, I did create a piece that's The Last Supper, but I let people be drawn to it, and then I explain to them that there's women's hands in it, just in case they'd like to buy it, and then they don't want to return it because it's women's hands.
Oh. I can't imagine that happening.
But it's a wonderful, you know, The Last Supper has been done. Mm-hmm. So you have to think of a different way to show it. And the piece that I did, I really think is more about the gesture of sharing.
It is.
And giving.
I believe it's called The Gift.
It's called The Gift.
Yes, which I love. Yes. And again, I think just like the sacred space that you create every single year, everyone has a different way to be drawn in and to hear Him and to feel His presence. And this particular space, I think it's more than the decompressing from the workshops.
It is. It becomes a destiny. It's a journey to come here. You know, it's a bit of a walk.
Mm-hmm.
And I ask people to come up here. And what they do is they say, well, it's in, you know, quite a ways. And I said, it's quite worth it. This morning I walked in and there was not a person in here. And I was just checking to see if everything was good. And I realized that it was a moment I could take. And I walked the labyrinth on my own, and at that moment...
Something special happened, didn't
something it? Something extraordinary happened. Mm-hmm. At that moment, I turned, while I was in the center of the labyrinth, I turned toward the chapel, and they were bringing in the Eucharist with the candles. And it's just the most profound moment for me to see the Eucharist coming in, and just that stirring inside of me that just wants to give it adoration. And it's, you know, giving God adoration. So,
well, this is certainly a place to breathe Him in and hear His voice in the stillness and hear what God speaks
absolutely.
To you. Absolutely. Thank you for your service of so many years and for continuing to bring
It's my joy and it's my pleasure.
Well, it's your gift and God has graced you most immensely.
Thank you very much.
Peace and blessings, my new friend.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And thank you all for being with us here at Los Angeles Religious Education Congress 2012 in the Sacred Space. Space.